You learn your craft, you do what you can, you get the tools together, but then in the end, you want your music to rise above all those things and to move people, not impress people. I don't want people sitting there saying, oh, that's very interesting, or wow, she's really good. No, I want those moments where it connects and somebody just feels something, they get lost in the music. Then I say, wow, that's success. Exactly this time of year in May, and every day I was going to the park and birding. And then I came home one day and I'm sitting at the piano and all of a sudden the opening idea happened and I thought, oh, what if this is a piece about migration and this idea that birds are citizens of the world. They know no boundaries of countries. They depend on us all collaborating as a world. If we don't start collaborating and caring about our planet collectively, birds are going to be, they're one of the first to show. So I thought, in a way it is political. And then when we go to Philippe on the accordion, I'm imagining that we're going into the mind of one little warbler that, you know, is flying above the clouds, you know, with millions of warblers, and they're all navigating by the magnetic field, the stars, the moon, all these, the land, all these different forces that are showing them where to go. Most of my music, in the end, I sit down to write and I think of sounds or I play something. And a lot of times, it's all of a sudden I realize the sound is about something. Like that day I sat down, I'm like, oh, that's birds. It's like, oh, okay, maybe I'll go with that and this will be a piece about birds. It's not like I sit down and say, oh, I want to write a piece about birds. You know, it doesn't happen that way for me. But I always say, as an artist, I think it's really important that you have a life outside of music, because to me, that's what feeds the music. The music is the response, the expression of rapture about life. And so many times as a musician, it starts when you're in college. You're under this pressure. You're comparing yourself to everybody else. And you're thinking, oh my God, I have to make a living doing this. How is this all gonna work out? And before you know it, you forget about that connection that music has to your life.
One, two, and three, and. Charging the time, and when you do the quintuplet, everybody who does the quintuplet, a crescendo, and then, you know, and then a short on the eighth note.
When I first started working with big bands, I would hear my music and just say, wow, it doesn't sound right. Play it again. Play it better. And I just thought if they played it more times, it would get better. And of course it does, because everybody gets to know the music and it gets better. But as a composer and somebody rehearsing the music, you have to really be able to understand what you can do to really make the music come out. And it takes years of experience to get good at that. And you really have to listen and separate yourself from it. And every group is different because every player is different.
One, two, and three, and. Thank you.
to me, that's the mystery, you know, this whole thing of I sit down to write music and I have a conception and a world in my head, the migration, the birds, everything. And then I come up with the musical ideas. Okay, now I have to put it into notation, which is very challenging. How do I get this sound, put it into little black dots and lines and things, and then all the players get it. Now they all have these instruments. It's a piece of pipe. You know, they're vibrating it with their lips, with their reed, or, you know, the string, all these different ways that people are creating sound vibration. Collectively, they do that. They try to get into this sound that I have in my head, make all their instruments vibrate. Now the vibration's in the air, and there's the audience, and that vibration's gonna hit their ear and hopefully give them the feeling that I had before I put my first note on paper. That's mysterious and magical and amazing. That's what can happen when you have an audience there. That's what I always hope to achieve.
I think you guys should just listen to the end of the piece.